जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव लर्नड इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर अबाउट द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ अ ग्लोब। हाउएवर, ग्लोब हैज सम लिमिटेशंस एज वेल। अ ग्लोब कैन बी यूजफुल व्हेन वी वांट टू स्टडी द अर्थ एज अ होल, बट व्हेन वी वांट टू स्टडी ओनली अ पार्ट ऑफ द अर्थ, फॉर एग्जाम्पल लाइक कंट्री, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू स्टडी अबाउट कंट्री, स्टेट, डिस्ट्रिक्ट, विलेज, सिटी एंड सो ऑन, इट इज़ जस्ट अ little help. In such a situation, we use maps. Now we will see what is map. A map is a representation or it is a drawing on the earth's surface or a part of it drawn on a flat surface according to a scale. But it is impossible actually to flatten a round shape completely. So yes, completely we cannot flatten, but then also it is a drawing on a flat surface. We find that maps are useful to us for various purposes. One map shows a small area and a few facts. Another map may contain as many facts as a big book. One more thing which is noticeable, that the book of maps are known as atlas. That you have read in the previous classes also. Atlases are of various sizes, measurements which are drawn on the different scale. Maps provide us more information than a globe. They are of different types. Few we will study here. First of all, we will study physical map, then political map, then thematic map. What is physical map? The map which shows the natural features of the earth, such as mountains, hills, plateaus, plains, rivers, oceans, these maps are called physical maps. Political maps, map showing the boundaries, showing the cities, towns, villages, countries, these are known as political map. Now we should know what is thematic map. Some maps focus on specific information such as road maps, rainfall maps, map showing distribution of forest industries and so on. There are several examples. These maps are thematic maps. Through thematic maps we get the information regarding that which place receives the heaviest rainfall, or the road map. As these days we always use Google map for chasing or for finding the location. Now we will talk about components of maps. There are three important components of map, that is distance, direction and symbol. First of all, we will study about distance. As we have already discussed that maps are drawings which reduce the entire world or a part of it to fit it on a sheet of paper, right? Like if you have to make a map of Varanasi, and if you have A4 size paper, so definitely you will have to draw the map on that A4 size paper only, and you will have to fit it out. So there will be definitely the ratio of distance, means the actual distance and the assumed distance we will assume on that particular sheet. So we can say that maps are drawn to reduce the scale or drawn to reduced scale, but this reduction is done very carefully so that the distance between the places is real. It can only be possible when a small distance on paper represents a large distance on the ground. Therefore, a scale is selected for this purpose. Now we should know what is scale. Scale is the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. For example, if the actual distance is 10 km and you are showing on the paper, on the sheet, that is about 3 cm or 4 cm, 2 centimeter. It is as per our own convenience we can show. So if it is 10 kilometer, the actual distance is 10 kilometer, and the distance which we are showing, that is 2 centimeter. So definitely 1 centimeter is equal to 5 kilometer, right? So in this way we can say that the scale of your drawing is the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on a map. Now, when large areas like the countries, continents are to be shown on a paper, then we use a small scale. For example, if 5 centimeter on the map shows 500 kilometer of the ground, it is called small scale map. Understood? Means when the large areas are to be shown on a paper, that is small scale map. And when the small areas like your city, town, or the map of your house or school, it is to be shown on a paper, then we use large scale map. For example, 5 centimeter is equal to 500 meters only on the ground. Generally, beta, large scale maps give more information than the small scale map. One more thing, that maps, always we find mistakes in maps. We cannot say map cannot be error free. And as the map will be smaller, there will be less error. And as the map means in the large scale map, we will have less errors. Whereas in small scale maps, there will be more errors. So this much only today. Now in our next class, we will discuss about another components. Till then, happy learning. Goodbye.